Fine. So yesterday we were speaking about this modify command. As like you have already seen, we had created this sketch, and as I mentioned, like this sketch is going to get the weak constraints. Okay, the weak constraints will be changed into strong constraints. Okay. Now what I am doing over here is I am selecting all these objects, then I am coming in modify, and in modify now you will notice that, sorry, I didn't select, just a moment, Basil is coming. Yeah, so now I need to select all these objects. I selected all these objects, I came in modify, and modify, you can see all these dimensions over here. Okay, I can expand this. So this 7.42, I need it as 8. Then this guy 10.46, I need it as 15. Then this guy 3.57, I need it as 5. This guy, and this 4.53, I need it as, let's say, 5 again. Okay. So this is how I can make my dimensions strong. You will notice that now all strong dimensions have come. Okay. Later on, what I can do over here is, I again selected these all objects. I came in modify, and from here, I can change one of the dimension, and I can see how my assembly is behaving, or rather how my link is behaving. Understood? Do you remember this thing we had done in our Katia? Do you remember it, everyone? We had animated.
Yes, sir.
We had animated that angle, right?
Yes, sir.
Now I think 2-3 guys were not there during Katia. We have some fresher guys for Creo. I will take one session today or tomorrow for them to show them that assembly, not assembly, the link mechanism. Okay. Till then, what the remaining guys needs to do is you need to repeat that same thing in Creo, where you will draw that kya tha wo apna cylinder and piston ka thing. Okay. You will draw that. You will come in modify. And there you will get the angle. There you will get the angle, and that angle you need to animate from 0 degrees to 360 degrees. Okay. And you need to check whether the link is behaving correctly or not. Okay. Will you do it, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Not the, yes, not sir. The fresher guys. I hear very less yes. Why? Everyone, I want,
yes,
everyone.
Those, yes, sir.
Are, yes, sir.
No, yes, still, sir. No, still, no. I want everyone.
Yes, sir.
Yes,
yes.
Sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. Now let's move to next part where we will learn these editing tools. Mirror. Now for mirror, what I require, what is the logic, what I will have to draw?
Axis chaser.
Center line. Okay, center, so line. Let us draw the center line. Then I will select these objects which I need to mirror. Then I will click on mirror, and then I will select this center line. Okay, so this guy, you will notice that will be mirrored. And from here, we will notice that I have also got the mirror ke constraints. Fine? Simple?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Good. Then I'm making undo.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir.
Yes.
एक बार please आप उसे repeat करेंगे.
Yeah, sure.
Screen lag हो गया था.
Yes. See, I am creating a center line. Okay. After creating a center line, I am creating half of my sketch, which I require. Then I am selecting the objects which I want to mirror, this object, this object, this, And guys, for selecting multiple object over here, I am pressing control button. Control will add the objects. So I selected these objects. Then I clicked on mirror. And then I selected the center line where I need to mirror. Simple?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Good. So first selecting the object, then mirror and the center line. And your object will be mirrored. Fine. Everyone is clear with this command?
Yes, sir.
Good. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Very good. Now next command is divide. It's a simple command. You will notice that this is a single segment which I want to divide in some parts. So I'm clicking on divide and I'm telling him I want to divide this segment at this location. I'm coming at this location and I am giving a click. I am coming at this location and I am giving a click. After completing, I will press the mouse middle button. Okay. So you will notice that this dimension has come. This dimension has come. I can give that dimensions. Okay. Simple. Divide command.
Yes, sir.
Good.
Yes, sir.
Then I have delete segment command, which is going to work as trim and delete. What we had quick trim in our Katia, that same thing is over here. I am coming here. I am telling him I don't want to see dimensions and I don't want to see the constraints also. Delete segment. If I click on this segment, you will notice that perfectly this segment is going to go out. So it is like your trim command, right? See this, see this. So what this guy is doing, he is taking the nearest boundary for trimming. If I am coming at this location, he is getting this boundary and this boundary. So this much of the segment will get trimmed. Simple, guys?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Good. Yes, sir.
Good. Now see here, I can use a fence option. Like I am coming at this point, my delete segment is on. I am coming at this point, click. And I am just drawing a line like this. Okay. My click button is pressed. I am taking my cursor on the objects which I want to select. And then I am releasing. So this is how you can do multiple trimmings. Simple?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
yes sir.
Sir.
Good. Then we have a corner tool which works in two ways. I have this line with me. And I have this line with me. Now I want to trim. I want to make a trimming operation. I can use this corner command. Corner, I'm clicking on this object and then I'm clicking on this object. You will notice that this portion has been kept. Okay. The other way around, corner, I'm clicking on this object. I'm clicking on this object. This portion is kept. So this is how you perform trimming operation theoretically. Practically, we use delete segment. Same way we can use extend with help of corner. So I'm coming in corner. I'm clicking on this object. I'm clicking on this object. It will create a corner coincide. Simple?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Good. Good. Now I'm creating a rectangle display dimensions. This guy is of 30 mm and this guy is of 15 mm. I want to rotate this or I want to scale this. For that I can select these objects. Then I can come here in rotate and resize. I am clicking rotate and resize. This is the dialog box for rotate and resize. First of all, if I want to move this object, I can use this tool for moving it horizontally and this for moving it vertically from its present position. Presently it is at its own 0,0. So let me try to push this object by 20 mm. On the right hand side. So from its original location, it shifted by 20 mm. I want to shift it by 50 mm on the right hand side. So now from the original position, your object is now shifted by 50 mm. This is your object. Okay? Simple?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Then vertically, if I
sir, want to repeat it,
yes, sir.
I selected these objects. After selecting these objects, I am coming in rotate and resize. Okay. After coming in rotate and resize, this guy over here, this guy is going to allow your object to move in X axis horizontally. For example, my object is presently at this location. Means what? The object is at its own 0, 0. Now from the object's 0, 0, I want to push this object, or rather I want to move this object by 50 mm, enter, from the 0, 0, that it's its own 0, 0, this object is moved by 50 mm horizontally. Same way, if I want to move it vertically, I can type over here by how much I want to move. For example, I want to push this object 30 mm vertically. So I am typing 30 over there and I am hitting enter. So now from the 0, 0 of that own object, the object is moved 50 mm in X axis, 30 mm in Y axis. Simple?
Yes, sir.
See, our object was somewhere at this location. Fine. We will use it practically. Then you will also understand what is the use of this. Okay. So presently that was move. Then you can rotate your object from here. You can come here and you can simply drag it like this. Okay. In this way. If at all you want to don't do it like this and you want to type out something, then you can do it from here. For example, I want to rotate this object by 90 degrees. So now the object has been rotated by 90 degrees. Okay. I'm confirming this command. Now check your object. Fine. Seems simple. Rotate and resize.
Yes, sir.
Good.
Yes, sir.
Now let us try to change the scale of it. I selected this object, rotate and resize. This fellow is for resizing it. Presently, it is at one scale. That is the scale which I have drawn. One scale, 30 as to 15. Now from this one scale, if I want to double it, so I will type 2. So what will happen? 30 ka size ho jayega 60 and 15 ka size ho jayega 30. I want to scale it down. I will select this, come in rotate and resize. Again, you will see that the scale is set to 1. I will change it to 0.5. So what happens now? The 60 ka dimension has been changed to 30. 30 ka dimension has been changed to 15. Simple?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
sir.
Yes, sir.
Good. And the last is the selection mode over here. Last is selection mode. I can come at this location. Presently, it's set to 1 by 1. You can go for chain or you can go for all geometry. Now what this all geometry is going to do? All geometry will select the entire geometry, only the geometry. Let me display the constraints also. See here. If I'm saying here select the entire geometry. So the entire geometry only has been selected. If I want to select all the objects, everything, I can click here for all, everything I want to select. Okay, then I want to select multiple object. I can say here chain, this object, you will notice that it has been selected. Understood? That is the meaning of chain. All the interconnected objects will get selected. Fine? Simple, guys?
Yes, yes sir.
And then yes, one yes, by yes. one by one, this is what we were using right now. Select this object. Hold down control button and you can select one by one object. Fine? Simple till here? Everything?
Yes, sir.
So we have covered this panel completely. You will notice that this same panel is bifurcated in analysis, tools, and view. Okay. Not tools. Still, we have to see all the relationships and everything that we will see during part modeling. Same like CATIA, like D1, D2, D3. Here you have SD1, SD2 in that way. View K related, all these things are over here. And then in analysis, you will see that this sketch mein ye jo hai, that is kept in analysis over here. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Very simple. So now we have covered all the tools which are required to create sketch in Creo. So tomorrow onwards, we will see how we can practically use these tools and create our sketches. So one sketch, same like CATIA, one sketch I am going to demonstrate. You will do that sketch. And then every day, one guy will explain